Welcome back, trainers. So, I was lucky enough to receive 2 Sinnoh Stones through PvP battles, once through losing and winning as well. So you do have the opportunity to win up to 3 prizes through the PvP matches a day. And it's going to be random on what you receive. You can get up to 3 Sinnoh Stones or you can get 0. It's just a matter of luck, okay? So I'm going to, in fact, use mine on right on here. Although a lot of people seem to like to use Venusaur. So you are going to be getting massive damage by that grass type. Anyways, with that said, let's go ahead and get myself a Rhyperior here. Now, this is the one I wanted to do first, and as a matter of fact, they fixed the size, as you will see here in just a moment. I'm definitely going to go with Smackdown for sure. As far as the charge move, well, guys, I don't have any more TMs. I have one that I got through a legendary raid earlier, but I'm not going to use it on it right now. Let's go ahead and see. I might purchase another move for it, though. So we'll go ahead and take a look at that. Look at him. Actually, whoa, geez, is it? Is the size a little big now, or? Let's see what CP. Let's see, guy. Can't see. 37.19 looks like. Okay, perfect. So he has Surf. Not bad. That's going to be some sort of coverage there. So we'll keep that. Because remember, those double charge, triple charge bar moves are going to be so good. And we're going to go over a Pokemon, as you will see here in the battle. That's going to be my Scizor. Scizor, however you like to say it. That thing is amazing because the charge moves it has go up so incredibly fast. You're going to be able to wear down their shields and or eat through their health immediately. So let's go ahead and get a new move here. See what we get. Stone Edge, beautiful. So we don't have Smackdown. We do have Mud Slap, which is going to be good against those Tyranitars. So is Surf, though. And remember, your quick move is going to be basically just as good as your charge, if not better, because you're going to be continuously hitting that. And they do actually put out massive damage. All right. So if you're doing super effective to that Tyranitar with Mud Slap, well, you're just going to be able to keep on tearing through it and probably not even use your charge move unless you know they're about to do theirs. That's probably when you want to use it. Okay, otherwise, you could probably just go right through it and hold it. Because remember what we were discussing earlier, you're going to be able to just contain that charge move and save it. And if you stack it up 2 times, you'll have 2 Surfs ready to go. And you can do that with Stone Edge. I don't think your Pokemon is going to last long enough to stack up 2 Stone Edges, but definitely 2 Surfs depending on what you're going up against. But remember, people like using Venusaur, so you got to look out. This thing is going to take massive damage from grass types being a rock and ground, but I'm very happy to have it a part of my team and it is completely maxed out. Awesome. Alrighty, so here we go. Another one of my secrets, Scizor. It's going to be a bug and steel type. Only going to have 1 weakness and that's going to be fire, but look out because it's going to be very weak to fire. So if they have a quick fire move, well, you're going to get eaten up fast and you need to use that to your advantage in certain situations where you have a quick move that is super effective to them. Maybe you want to just keep going and going and save your charge move for the next Pokemon if you know you'll be able to take a hit. Possibly keep using your quick move and then use your shield. Stack up your charge moves for the next Pokemon if you know you're going to be able to take a few quick moves and then get off 2 charge moves. Bam, bam, when that next Pokemon comes in, make them use a shield and or just completely tear right through their Pokemon's health. So it's a strategy like that that you need to think about. Also, saving your shields towards the end is a good idea, but it really depends on the situation. And these battles are fairly even, guys. It revolves around skill and strategy. It also is very neck to neck for the most part. Alrighty, trainers, next up we have one of my favorite Pokemon and I'm so happy that I can actually use it for PvP. And guess what? It's pretty good. So what is Scizor weak against? Just fire, extremely weak to fire. And this is gonna be a water and dragon type that is gonna be extra resisting fire types, so it can come in and save the day and take very reduced damage from those fire type moves if needed. Now it's going to have Dragon Breath, Outrage, and Hydro Pump. Might change those moves in the future. Definitely going to keep Outrage if you have that for sure. Hydro Pump is questionable. Maybe Blizzard, but I don't know. That still works great. Alright, so here we have an amazing Alakazam. So keep in mind, it is going to be a pretty big glass cannon, but putting out super good damage. Confusion to take out those poison and fighting types. Then you have Dazzling Gleam, very nice legacy charge to hit those dragons extremely hard, as well as those fighting types. And then you have Shadow Ball to go for those Mewtwo's, Metagross, and anything else in between. So that is some nice coverage there for the top tier Pokemon. It's just these glass cannon Pokemon, I'm afraid to put them in there because those quick moves just eat right through them. And before you know it, you're barely able to get off one of your charge moves. And then you're going to have to use your shield if you're thinking to yourself, oh, right, so it's about to die, but its charge move is ready. What do I do? Use my shield and sacrifice one of those or let it faint without even getting off a charge move? It's those situations. And when it comes down to that, I kind of recommend you use your shield and then go for that charge move because you're going to either make your opponent use their shield or defeat their Pokemon or take a big chunk of their health off instead of wasting that accumulated energy. Righty, now let's go ahead and go over some of these Community Day Pokemon because they're absolutely destroying when it comes down to PvP. You may have seen this green fella around a few times if you've done a few PvP matches yourself, and that is going to be Venusaur with Frenzy Plant and, of course, Sludge Bomb with that nice weather boost, almost doing just as much as Frenzy Plant. Being a two charge bar move for both Frenzy Plant and Sludge Bomb, you're going to have the opportunity to continuously spam your opponent with massively strong moves. Not to mention Venusaur has great defense and could take hits for days depending on what you're going up against. Because I personally have went through teams using just a Venusaur, and I know others who have done the same. So if I were you, I would probably invest in a few of these, make sure they're in the correct league, and get it going there. So there we have my Master League Venusaur. No secret anymore. Let's go ahead and take a look at my Ultra League, and there we go. Of course, Sludge Bomb. And then for my Great League, we have Petal Blizzard. And I'm definitely not going to TM that anytime soon. Once I have fixed all my other Pokemon, I guess I'll go back to this one and make it have Sludge Bomb, obviously. But Petal Blizzard is something you're not going to really want too much. So there you have Venusaur, extremely good for every tier. Highly recommended if you enter into a fight with a fire Pokemon on the opposite end and you have the Venusaur, it's not going to do so hot. Any Pokemon that is going to go up against their weakness right from the beginning is not going to be doing so hot, right? And that is actually going to determine whether or not you're going to almost win or lose. Not necessarily all the time, but it's a big factor. So you have to go into battle with the mindset of putting a Pokemon that will not take super effective damage from that many types. And that is just pretty much key right there. And then we have Charizard. And I really shouldn't have bought the extra move. It doesn't cost much. Let's go ahead and look at it. This is going to be the same price. And a Raiolu is actually going to be 25 candies. I can't remember the exact Stardust, but it's going to be a lot less than Lucario. Somebody left a comment saying, oh, well, for every Pokemon species, it's still going to be the same price. Not necessarily. Lucario is a great example. 75 candies when you're actually Lucario to get a secondary move. And then for Riolu, it's going to be 25 candies and a much lower Stardust cost. So, yes, that is actually a real thing. Charizard, right here, shouldn't have bought this extra move. Not really worth it. If you had something like, let's say, Charizard with Dragon Claw, you're definitely going to probably want to buy another move for that because you're going to have that nice Dragon coverage as well as that Fire for that Grass type or going up against Steel Pokemon because Dragon Claw is not going to be very effective against those Steel types. And fairies as well, but you can just hit them with fire, neutral damage. So it's just food for thought. So if you do have the Community Day Charizard and you're thinking about buying another move, having, you know, overheat for your secondary move would be great if you wanted to use your shield once, accumulate an even stronger move, and hit them really hard. And then you know they're not going to use their shield. And that is another thing I went over in my last video. You don't want to go for those bigger charge moves when they still have their shields, knowing that they might use it, because you would have wasted that little bit of extra time trying to charge up that bigger bar as opposed to just using your Blast Burn and, you know, making them use their shield all the same. So there you have Charizard. Pretty good as far as coverages. Not really too much if you have the Community Day one, but if you have an older Legacy, you're looking pretty good for coverage there. This Dragon Claw is not Legacy, actually. So anyways, let's move on to Blastoise. Now, this one right here, I am very pleased with, okay? So, Hydro Cannon and Water Gun. Water Gun being one of the most OP moves in PvP, personally, I think. It does so much damage to everything, right? If you're going up against a grass Pokemon, it's not going to do that much, but for the most part, everything else, it's hitting them pretty hard. And then you have Hydro Cannon. Blastoise being a fairly tanky Pokemon, be able to take a few hits, you know, depending on the type you're going up against. And you just might be able to stack up that Hydro Cannon. And what I did earlier this morning was stack up two Hydro Cannons, go into the next Pokemon, hit them once, hit them twice, that Pokemon was done. And it is quite amazing. So you might want a little bit of coverage on your Blastoise, possibly Ice Beam, because then you'll be able to hit Dragons and grass types for a little bit more damage. All right. So Blastoise is also a great addition, and I highly recommend using it. As far as investing in it, I say, yeah, go for it if you're up for it. Maybe have some around that area for each league. So just kind of play with it first to see how you like it. Alrighty, trainers. And as we close out this video, I want to show you a little example as something not to do on my end personally. Now, I should have blocked this right here, but I was being greedy with my shield for some reason. And if I would have blocked this, you do see she still has two shields, but my confusion is so strong, I would have been able to surpass that and been able to take the win. But I was being greedy, thought I was going to be able to block another one, who knows. Alrighty, trainers, so I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like, and I'll be bringing you more tips on PvP and battles. So what I plan to do for the next few videos, I know some of you may not completely enjoy this, but I know others will in fact enjoy this a lot, is just the PvP battles themselves, no commentary, just going into there so you can witness the battles, kind of like my gym battles like I was doing back in the day, but just with PvP. Don't worry, I'll still be bringing commentary once, but I'm going to be dropping those as well, so look forward to those. And with that said, trainers, thank you for watching. Got ourselves a real Rhyperior, nice full size, looking great, so big you can't even see the CP. And I'll be catching you all next time. Take care.